so that they can have a choice to choose between various technologies and move ahead with their careers in. So that idea was done in an offline mode, in a physical mode, but due to the current situation of pandemic, we have to move everything in a virtual setup, right? So this time we were planning to do it from last 1 or 2 months. So finally, we came up with a plan, complete schedule of how the events will go through. And we finally came up with a lot of events in this month of January. So the coming batch of NIT Jalandhar, we had held a lot of events for them in the month of January, starting from Android study jams. Like 3 sessions were conducted for Android study jams, and they were able to make very like good apps for them. Like if you see, they're they're very beginners, right? So when we talk about Android study jams, then we conducted one workshop on Explore ML, where people were introduced to what machine learning is and what data science is and how they can pursue their careers in machine learning. So that it was just a kickstarting session, so that if people develop interest in machine learning, they can move ahead with developing their projects, developing, taking machine learning further as a career choice or as something that they can like explore more on. Next, we conducted a workshop on UI UX, that is product design. Like, it's a booming field and people are not aware about this field. Like, if you are innovative, you are creative, and you have some certain sense of passion for design. So UI UX is something that is perfect field for you. So we had a workshop on UI UX, where students are introduced to what UI UX is, what are the career opportunities in UI UX, how you can start, and the complete roadmap to UI UX was given. Apart from that, we have conducted one web development bootcamp, where students were introduced to HTML, CSS, JavaScript, also they made a very good project in this workshop. So these all technologies we covered in the first batch for our batch of 2024. Along with that, some students of other colleges joined in these workshops, and like the overall response was very good. So all the credits goes to the team of Developer Student Clubs, NIT Jalandhar. The students have been so innovative, so motivating. They have been like very creative, and they have come up with so great ideas that we can deliver sessions. Like it's really commendable. So when we talk about coming to this hack MOL, basically it's, I would say, the conclusion of all those events. Like we have this hackathon, basically it's a beginner friendly hackathon where what we are looking forward is to remove the fear of the word hackathon, right? If you're not aware of the hackathon, for example, you are in first year or second year, so you might be afraid of the word hackathon. What hackathon is? Like, is it something where we need to go and hack? Or is it hacking your Instagram ID or Facebook ID? So removing all those barriers, what exactly is a hackathon and how you can approach a hackathon in an easier way so as to remove that fear, this hackathon is basically we considered making it suitable for beginners. So beginners, when we talk about, there can be people from first year, second year. So it was open to all. We made it open to all. We want to reach as many people as possible so that we can remove these barriers of unawareness and like not being comfortable with the words that are familiar in tech, right? So we, along with my team, we came up with the concept of Hack MOL, that is Hack at the Rate Machine Month of Learning. So it is basically a 36 hours mentor-led community hackathon. It's totally student-based, completely organized by students, completely organized by student team, completely mentored by student teams, and everything is being done by students. So we want all of you, like if you are coming up here for the very first time, you are participating in your first hackathon. So we also want that you, in your future, you should come up with such things so that you can help your coming juniors, or you can help your coming branches or batches. So this is how we give back to society or give back to the community who have like brought us here. So whether you are a beginner or an expert, there's a perfect chance to showcase your skills and witness a competitive yet inclusive developer community around it. So this is the second time, like first time it was conducted in a physical mode last year, January, Feb. And this time we have made it everything in a virtual mode. So this is basically a 36 hours long hackathon. We'll discuss about what all events and what is the schedule, but this was just a brief about hack mode. Yeah, so this is being organized by Developer Student Clubs, NIT Jalandhar. Developer Student Clubs basically was set up in January 2019. And with the setup of Developer Student Clubs at NIT Jalandhar, we organize a lot of events. Like till date, if I make a counting figure, it's around 30 plus events, workshops, seminars, online events, offline events, coding events related to data, related to competitive programming, related to Android, like all the technologies we have covered. And we have also invited people from various fields of technology who have been masters in the field to deliver sessions to guide students And we have till now reached and impacted close to 10,000 people. So taking all this forward, we are trying to increase our reach as well as to impact more and more students. This is basically what we are here for. This hackathon is all about, and it's not about winning or losing. It's about learning. So the major focus thing that we want in this hackathon is learning. So the major outcome, what I want from you all, like we organizers wish, is even if you learn something, any new technology, anything you explore, so that is what you will be winning from this hackathon. And do remember, like, certificates won't matter at all. It is the learning that will take you anywhere. Whether if you're thinking of a good career, if you're thinking of higher studies, it is your skills that will matter at the end. And you will definitely remember these words whenever you will be sitting for your placements, or you will be sitting for your job interviews, or you'll be giving some competitive exam, right? So this was all about the club, the developer student clubs, as well as coding club NIT Jalandhar. So both of them are conducting in collaboration. And let me introduce to the team that has done all the work behind this hackathon. That was, like, I would say, the real motivation behind this hackathon, and who have worked really hard looking out for people, setting up Discord, looking out for companies sponsoring us, looking out for everything, holding meetings. Like, it was a lot of work if we talk about for conducting this hackathon. So if we talk about the team currently, so let me introduce myself. My name is Arsh Goyal. I am currently a final year undergraduate at NIT Jalandhar. I'm pursuing my bachelor's of technology in ECE, and I'm in my eighth semester. If I talk about my professional career, I have been, till now I have interned at Samsung Electronics Bangalore. Also, I have been an intern, a data science intern at Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. I've also worked as an intern at a startup of Japan, Tokyo, that is BitGrid Incorporation. And when you talk about, I have been a part of various hackathons. I have, like, been a finalist at various hackathons, won various hackathons, and I have a real experience of how a hackathon works and what is the benefit of hackathons. So that's why this was the motivation why we are conducting this hackathon. So we can take it to even anyone who is not aware of the word hackathon. So this was all about me. So let me introduce to my super amazing team who have worked in this hackathon and who have been really great working with me coordinating and, like, coming up with this concept and bringing you up on board, everything. So there are a lot of, like, currently the team that you might see on the website also, we are a 5-member team. So I'll introduce my team. So we have Pradyuman Gupta. He's a third year undergraduate student from computer science and computer science department, NIT Jalandhar. He's like one of the content creation, as well as he has been the overall coordinator along with me, and he has been managing Discord. You might have seen he was the one who is answering your queries on Discord, and he has managed everything very well. So to talk about next, we have Pavan. He's super talented, super amazing. He is an incoming intern at DE Shaw and Company. And talking about his skills, he's a very good competitive programmer, and he'll also be helping you within throughout this event. And he has, like, worked upon the website, like the website that you see, like, on which you registered for this hackathon. So it was done by Pavan and Harsh. So Harsh is another team member, Harsh Badhai. He is basically a UI UX enthusiast, and he has worked with various startups, various companies as a UI UX product design intern. Along with that, like, he is very fond of photography, and he has like I would say he's a very creative person, and every creativity that came into our hackathon was a part of what Harsh Badhai did. So if Harsh is listening, I'm not able to see if Harsh is available. So and we have Lakshay along with us. He is, like, I would say, the backbone of this hackathon. He has been working immensely for marketing, conducting meetings with companies. He has been reaching out to people, conversing with a lot of students, conversing with a lot of companies. And, like, overall, I would say he has managed this excellently, and he will be there for your support throughout this hackathon. And this was all for introduction. Like, I hope you got a pretty well idea of what this hackathon is and why we are conducting this hackathon. And almost most of your doubts are cleared. Now we'll be describing this hackathon in a bit of elaboration. So I would request Pradyuman, if Pradyuman is able to listen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Pradyuman, please go ahead and just familiarize with what this hackathon is. And at the end, we can have a query session where we can discuss their queries. Fine. So all the best. Good luck.
Okay. Thank you, Harsh, sir. So as sir already mentioned that it is a beginner friendly hackathon where our main focus is to bring out the fear. Like we don't want you to get afraid of these hackathons and all this technical stuff. That's why we are mentioning again and again, this is a beginner friendly. And even if you are starting something, obviously you should participate and you should move forward with this. So moving on to our next section, let's talk about the schedule. I would like to give you a walkthrough about the schedule which we'll be following for the next 2 days. So first of all, we are already have this kickstart session going on. Now, the first thing we will be having is that hacking begins tomorrow at 10 a.m. That is on 30th January. What we'll be having there is that we'll be having an event where we'll have a speaker, Dave. He's the founder of Hackathons International. He will be guiding us on the topic like how to ace hackathon. He will be giving all those tips and tricks you should be following that are very beneficial. Then secondly, we will be having the round one evaluation. That would be in the evening tomorrow at 5 p.m. Now this step is very crucial one and I want all of you to take proper care for this one. In round one evaluation, you have to present your idea to the mentors in the evaluation session. You have to present your idea to the mentors. Your ideas will be evaluated. And if you're using any pre-built project or any part of any pre-built project, you have to state that particularly, like very clearly, the mentors will take note of it. Because if you would hide those details, that if you're using any pre-built project and we get to discover it later, then it will come under plagiarism and you will be disqualified. So I'm taking great emphasis on this one that please do mention here if you are using any pre-built project or any part of it. And the most important thing here is that you are not allowed to submit any project as it is, which you have already submitted in any previous hackathon. As I have already answered on Discord also, that we have certain platforms and tools where your submissions are like judged for plagiarism. And certainly we have a session also for the same. So I'd request you not to do this. Any misconduct will have some drastic effects, you already know. Then we'll be having some round two evaluation that will be on 31st January at 4 p.m. And in both these evaluation rounds, presenting any PPT is completely optional. It's not like mandatory, it's completely optional. If you want, you can do that. No issues about that. Now, after the round two evaluations, your final submission, the deadline would be on 31st January. The deadline would be at 10 p.m. Indian Standard Time. All these time zones is Indian Standard Time only. So there will be no extra time provided. I'm telling you this in advance that there will be no extra time after this. On 31st January at 10 p.m., your final submission should be there on DevFolio platform. And in that final submission, what you have to do is you'll be sharing the GitHub repository of your project and a video, like about 2-3 minutes. In which you will give a walkthrough of your project, like the working prototype and all this. So we'll be guiding in detail at that moment only. We'll give you all these details in PDF format also. So you'll getting all these guidelines. Then after this final submission, we are having a very interesting session, I would say, that from 31st January at 11 p.m. After this, till the time we declare the results, you will have a slot where we will allow all of your teams to see all the successful submissions by other teams. It's like a bounty session, if you can get it. So what we have to do is, if you find any projects which you think is completely copied from somewhere, or if you have seen that projects being submitted at any previous hackathon, you have to report that to us before this time ends, that is on 1st February, 12 noon. You have to tell us with a particular reasonable proof that this project is being copied from that particular source or anything. You have to be something concrete proof. You have to bring some concrete proof. And there we'll take care of those teams which are copying and all this, okay? All this misconduct. So this is the schedule we'll be following. Now, next thing we'll be having is CodeChef Hours. In CodeChef Hours, what we'll be having is you will be given some puzzles and fun questions, and the time will be 1 hour for each question. We'll be having 6 such slots, and for every successful submission, one random participant will be chosen by Code Chef, and obviously that participant will be awarded with the Code Chef Goodie Kits. So this is our Code Chef Hours, which will be taking 6 times in the whole duration. And first Code Chef Hour will be scheduled today only, like in few hours after the Kickstart event. Next workshop we'll be having is resume building workshop by Merge Intern. In this, what we'll be having is we have a Merge Intern as our sponsors. So what we'll be having is a certain speaker will be giving you guidance and certain tips and tricks about building your resume, which obviously, you know, plays a very vital role in getting all these placements and interviews, all these things. So that will be a very important workshop for you all. And then moving forward, as I told you about the evaluation. So round one evaluation, which will be taking place on 30th January, like tomorrow at 5 p.m. So in that, what we'll be evaluating is your basic idea, that what is your basic idea and the initial, like your project in the initial phase itself. Whatever you have done, you have to show it. It's not like if you're copying somewhere and showing us, okay, I'm doing this job. So you have to be very careful about that one. We'll be evaluating your basic idea as well as your project in the very initial phase. It's not like we want complete. It's very initial phase, no problem. Your idea will be evaluated in the first one. In the round two evaluation, that is on 31st January at 4 p.m., there your prototype, like by that time, your so somewhat your prototype should be quite ready, that it is quite presentable. So in that round, your prototype will be evaluated. And all these things will be done by the mentors which are assigned to you. You will getting the list of like which mentor has been allotted to you. And obviously we'll take care that the mentors are having the expertise of that particular field in which you are making your project. So certainly we'll be circulating a form for you where you will give all these details to us. Now, next thing, as I told you about the challenge phase, it's like a bounty session where you have to, if you can find, you have to find any project which are using any pre-built things or just, you know, plagiarism. So obviously on successful report of any plagiarism or any bounty, you will be also rewarded. So take it quite seriously. And one thing, after the declaration of result, that is on 1st February 12 noon, no such queries will be entertained that I saw this project at somewhere else and why this project, why that project. You are given time, proper time, you can report that to us. Now in final evaluation, as I told you, there will be certainly few teams, and if we think, we might take interviews of some teams. If required, we will take interviews of some teams before the declaration of the result. So that is all for the evaluation and final evaluations. Now, as you have, as you might have noticed that we have special tracks in the prizes. So we have special tracks from Tezos, Matic, Portis, and Agora. Now, what we have is that all these three, Tezos, Matic, and Portis are blockchain platforms where the eligibility criteria is already posted on our Discord under prizes channel. You can check them out. And Agora is a SDK for real-time applications. So basically the most important criteria for eligibility is that you have to build your project on these platforms or use this SDK in your project, then only you will be eligible. And for getting the whole list, you all the eligibility criteria, you can refer to our Discord channel where we have already posted this. So obviously we are having certain prizes, as you can see in these special tracks. So this is a pretty good opportunity for you all. Now moving forward, like the judging criteria, like how your projects will be judged. So take special care of this one. First of all, your solutions should be unique, not like in vague terms. It should be something unique and it should have a real life impact. And obviously with the impact, you must have a particularly reasonable user experience, which is quite good to familiarize with. And then we will be also evaluating your project on the technical achievement and the future scope of your project. And as you might have already noted in the prizes, that first two teams will get this opportunity to turn their project into potential products. And some company may also sponsor you if you have that potential. So there are lots of future scopes from our sponsor side also. So you can take care of that one also. Now for judges, as you can see, some of our judges are Vinit Shadev. He's software engineer at Postman. We have Rijraj Singh. He is the Google developer expert for Web and Firebase. And then we have Dave Bell. As I already told you, he's the co-founder of Hackathons International and one of our sponsors. Then another thing, the official communication medium we'll be using is Discord. As you might have got all, like all of you have got the link also in your mail IDs. If you haven't joined it till now, I request you to join this because all these official announcements will be taking place on Discord only. And as you can see, after joining, you have to head on to this first channel called Start Here, where you have to upgrade your role to hacker. If you don't do that, you won't get access to all these channels. So I repeat, if you have joined and not upgraded your role, you have to go in Start Here and get your role upgraded. Then only you will get access to the whole server. And obviously you can see we have certain, like many channels for obviously all the things. If some things are required, we can obviously do that in real time, no issues. Now for the next thing, mentorship. As I told you, mentors will be assigned to you. We'll be assigning your mentors and we'll take special care that the project you are making, the technology you're using, the mentor is having expertise in that particular technology. And you can ask doubts throughout the hackathon in the Ask Mentor channel. You are having this channel in Discord. So you can ask your technical doubts to your mentors. And if you want to discuss something, then you also have Mentor Connect voice channels also in the Discord. And this is pretty much about it, about the mentorship. And these mentors will also evaluate your project in the evaluation sessions. So moving on to our next thing is about our sponsors. So as you already know, you all registered on our DevFolio platform. So DevFolio is one of our gold sponsors. Then we have Hackathons International on board with us. They'll be providing some hackers toolkit you might have received by now. Then we have Track sponsors, as I already mentioned, Tezos, Fortis, Matic, and Agora. So these are Track sponsors and we have special prizes in these tracks. Now we also have on board with us Coding Blocks, Code Chef, Coding Ninjas, Geeks for Geeks, Merge Intern, and Interview Cake as our sponsors. So a huge thanks to all these guys. Like they are the ones supporting us for many things for this particular event. And as Arsh sir already introduced you to my whole team, this is our team which are working tirelessly to make this happen. So let's hope for getting this a successful one. Now, after answering lots of questions, these are some common questions which I think should be answered right now. So first of all, I'm a beginner. Can I participate? Obviously, you can participate as we are pitching our hackathon as beginner friendly. So we all want you to participate no matter what your expertise is. Don't worry about it. If you need any guidance, mentors are there to guide you. Anybody with any expertise level can participate, and students from any college, any year are welcome. Even from schools, students are welcome. Now, how I submit my project alone? So here's the thing. We are not accepting individual submissions. You are supposed to make teams, and the team size is minimum 2, maximum 5. You are not allowed to submit your project alone. Like individual participants will be discarded. I'm telling you, there is an option to submit your project individually, but we won't be considering that project for evaluation. So keep this in mind. This is a team event. You have to make teams, at least pair up with a single person so that you are a pair of two, like pair of two participants minimum, but teams are necessary. Now, how to claim track prizes? As I told you, track prizes are like quite interesting ones. And in order to claim that, I have already posted, DSC has already posted the details in the prizes section. You can check that out on our Discord. Now, are there any themes, problem statements as such? So no, we are not having any problem statements or themes as such. The reason is because we don't want to limit you. It is an open innovation. Whatever you feel like is innovative and serves its purpose in real life, you should go for it. Now, one more query I was getting was about that the prizes, like only the projects built on those Tezos, Portis, Matic, and Agora.io will be getting the prizes. No, these are the special tracks. these are different from overall prizes. So for this hackathon, we will be having first, second, and third prizes. Obviously, these will be overall prizes. These special track prizes are for only those teams which make their project, which use these tools in their project and use these platforms for their project. So for those students, we have separate prizes also, and overall prizes are always there. And apart from these, there is something for everybody. So if you are participating and successfully submitting your project on DevFolio, so you will be getting something. So don't worry about it. Now, what next? So this was pretty much about our hackathon, all the details and schedule.
Let's give them an introduction of our mentors who are there for this hackathon. So sure. Let's, if it's possible from your end to present the website so that we can give them a go through of the website also.
Just a minute, sure.
Yeah. And let's introduce the mentors. I would request if any mentor is available right now, he or she, if he's comfortable in turning on his camera and introducing, we would love to have them here. Just a minute. Try to present the website.
Yes, sir.
Hello, everyone.
Sorry, is my screen visible?
Yeah. Okay, fine. So just to brief you about who will be mentoring you in this hackathon, we have people from who have achieved something, who have been perfect at some technologies, who have already been at some companies, or who have already been into software development and related fields. So we have a lot of them here. Like, we have Umang Sharma, placed in Microsoft. We have Kushal Vijay, placed in Microsoft. We have Rasam Anand. She's placed in UHG Optum. We have Abhinav Rastogi, he's placed in Lowe's. Along with that, we have Prabhat Sharma. He's placed in Amazon, and he'll be mentoring you for blockchain. So his name is not there because he has been recently onboarded. I hope if Prabhat is there. Next, we have people from various technologies like Adamya is there. He's the DSC lead currently for NIT Jalandhar. We have Amardeep. He will be guiding you for cloud. We have Aditya Manchanda. He will be guiding you for machine learning projects. Praveen Agarwal, he is one of the winners of Solution Challenge 2020, and he'll be guiding you for Android. And Kunal Garg, we have for web development. So if we have any of these mentors, I would love you to just turn on your mic or camera if you're comfortable with it, and you can introduce a bit about you. So we have Kushal, I can see. Yes, Kushal.
Hello guys, I'm Kushal Vijay, and thank you Ash for giving such a sweet introduction. I hope you guys can hear me clearly.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Kushal, it's fine.
Okay. So I hope this particular, the coming next 2 or 3 days will be a cracking of the hackathon. And I saw a few questions. You were pretty confused about the, since Pradyuman has mentioned it's a beginner friendly hackathon. So there is no restriction to a blockchain project will be given preference or a web project will be given preference. There is nothing like that. As he also mentioned, we prefer innovation. And that is the most important thing that matters in this hackathon. So I wish you all the best. And being the mentor, I'm expecting a lot of doubts from you guys. So just hit me up whenever you come across any problem that you face. And so let's get started with it.
And they will be given a tag of mentor in the Discord channel. If you're comfortable with using Discord, so you can find all of the mentors in Discord with the tag of mentor. You can connect with them. There'll be separate mentor connect channels. You can talk with them. You can present your PPT. You can discuss your idea. So they'll be there for you, right? So if anyone else is there right now, else we can continue with the doubt sessions. We have Prabhat. Yeah, Prabhat. So he'll be mentoring you for blockchain. Try
it,
if Prabhat is able to unmute. Yeah.
Yeah, hello guys. Can you listen me, Ash? Can you confirm?
Yes, Prabhat.
Yes, sir, Prabhat.
It's audible.
Yeah, echo. Okay, hello guys. I'm Prabhat from CSE final year. And I think this hackathon is going to be amazing. And you're all going, I want you to be sure that you're all going to learn so much in this hackathon. And ask us anything, any mentor will be more than ready to help you. And on my personal note, I would like to inform you that I'm more towards the business side. So I'll be grilling you on the business impact and real life use cases of your project. So be ready for that. Because if you build anything and it's not of use to anybody, then it's as good as not being built, okay? So yeah, that's it from my side, and I welcome you all to the hackathon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Prabhat. Do we have anyone else right now joining us in the opening ceremony, or who is comfortable in introducing? Else we can continue with the doubt session, Pradyuman. Right?
Okay, so I think we can continue then.
Yeah, sure.
So one more thing I would like to add here is that many of you were having doubts that what should we build? You were concerned about your ideas. So I would like to tell you, as Arsh sir already mentioned, that you can contact these mentors. They are also having tag @mentors on the Discord. You can contact them in Ask Mentors channel. You can also discuss with them. So the idea is you can discuss with them what ideas you should pick up and how you should proceed with that. So all the technical help you need, mentors will provide you and obviously grill you in the evaluation session. So you can get help, all the technical help from their side, and don't hesitate. The first, like, most important thing is don't hesitate. You are free. Nobody is judging you without any, like, it's not like you are getting job or something. It's not that judgment. So you should not hesitate about all this. Okay. If there is any technical query, you can ask them. And for rest of the things, our team is already there to help you out at any given time, as you have already seen in the days come. Now, what next? So this was pretty much about our hackathon. Now, what we are having is we are having this Hacker Connect voice channel on our Discord, where we'll be answering your questions if you have any. So you can find our team in Hacker Connect. Obviously, it's like Hangout session, so be chilled. It's nothing so serious. And now, if you have any questions related to all these things, you can ask right now, if there is any. Yeah. Okay, so I can see a few questions in the chat box. So first of all, this one about, as I said, it is a beginner friendly event and beginners have idea about web and app development and what to do about blockchain, Ethereum and crypto. So obviously you got to explore some fields by yourself only. So I would also say the same, that you need to explore these fields by yourself. If you need any help in this, mentors will be there to help you out. Now, one more thing, if any of you are having any doubts, you can raise your hand in the Zoom itself. My team will unmute you to get your query. Okay, so next thing we have, can we choose challenge track now also? Obviously, you can choose your challenge track now also. There's no limitation for that. Hackathon is world level competition. Yes, this hackathon is open to all, and we have some participants which are not from India. That's why we need to mention all those time zones and all these things. Okay, shall we get any team channels too? So no, you won't be given any team channels because we have already fixed one official communication medium. We don't want to restrict you for your communications also. So what you can do is you can communicate yourself on whatever platform you want. Obviously, there are some privacy concerns on many things. So you can coordinate that yourself wherever you want. You are totally free to do that. Now, but what to do if you don't have any ideas at all? If you don't have any ideas at all, Google is your best friend. You can search for many ideas. Obviously, man, how are you dealing with all these things? You have to Google. You have to explore all these by yourself. See, the thing is, if you'll ask anybody to just give me any idea, that will not be a unique one. And obviously, it won't be like very much from your field. Like, that uniqueness will not be there. That will be quite mainstream. So I will again tell you that try to explore yourself. If you need any help, mentors are already there, but try to explore yourself first before anything. Okay, so if members are expert in different fields, then how to tackle it? Okay, so this question is from, okay. Obviously, this is, I'll tell you, this is a boon. This is a very great thing to have. As you already saw that in our own team, we have people from varied fields. And obviously, you need these kind of fields. Like if everyone is working on the same field, then who will be the one, if everybody is working on the back end only, who will be the one designing your front end? Like how the website should look and how things should come up on the website. So you get it. You need people from different fields. How to tackle it? You got to do that yourself. How you communicate with them and how you vibe with them, that is something upon you. You need to do this. And this, I'll tell you honestly, this is the thing which is the key point of hackathons. You meet variety of people, like totally strangers. You try to work with them and you try to come up with a particular solution in a very limited time. So this is the beauty of hackathons and you should go for it. Okay, can you please explain about the challenge tracks? Okay, so as I told you, we have prizes in different categories. So obviously, first of all, we have overall prizes like first, second, third. And apart from those, if you're using the platforms and tools from our sponsors, you will be eligible for a different prize category also. That will be different from the overall prizes. And for getting the details about the eligibility, you can head to our prizes channel on our Discord server. Okay, we have already code for our website, but it is not used anywhere. Can we use it? Okay, so for this, I would say you have to give all the details about your project. Okay, in the first evaluation session, like mentors will be noting it down, like which website you are talking about. And you have to also show your code to the mentors. And if required, they'll ask you to send them the code of your website or anything. So as I told you, there's a limitation of how much you can use. Like you cannot copy paste the whole project. Obviously, you can use certain parts. That's totally fine. Can we make a website with HTML, CSS, JavaScript? Absolutely. Most of the websites are built with those tools only. No issues. Sir, and my team familiar with front end. So what to do about back end, or we can build a static website? Static website will do. I won't say it is not like it's not eligible. You can't build that. You can build that, but it should serve the purpose. Like the main idea is whatever you built, that purpose should be served. So take care of this one. How are you going to solve that problem? So you have to take care of this one. What you can do is you can contact in the team building. Like we have given you particular time also. So you can go into team building and search for teammates who know backend. That will be very beneficial for you. As I already mentioned, people from varied fields are a boon in a developer's team. So take care of this one. Now, like I can do, I'm participating solo in this hackathon. So what should I do? If you are participating solo, then you should head to team building channel for hackathon and find a pair for yourself. You cannot participate individually. That's a limitation. Yes, it is answered. And any Ethereum and crypto resources are available for us, like API or something to make our Android app. You can contact your mentor, like Prabhat sir. He'll be guiding you for this particular query only. I won't answer this one. Prabhat sir will answer you. Can we win by making the website with HTML, CSS, JavaScript? See, the thing is, just by looking at a participant, I can't say you can win or you can't. Obviously, everybody has the potential. And with these three things, great stuff can be built with these three tools. You should use it efficiently. You can do that. So yes, you can win. Can you explain about submission of project? Okay, so about this one, submission of project will take place on 31st at 10 p.m. Like that will be the deadline. So we'll be giving you the details about that also, and will be available there in the chat section also. So I'll tell you in detail there also. The thing is, you will have to submit your GitHub repository, public repository, and a video walkthrough of your working prototype. So you will need these two things at the time of submission. So take care of these two from the starting. Is participation in CodeChef Arts optional? Obviously, it is completely optional and it has some goodies. So you know what to do. Sir, it can be two teams are doing work on same problem. How can we get to know that, and will it? Okay, so if two teams have not decided to, like 10 person are there and they want to work on the same project, if that is not the case, then obviously there will be some differences, which I know, like handwritings are different. Similarly, the type of code you write will be different. and the type of problems you solve will be somewhat different. That can be, you know, you can see that easily. So don't be like two teams working on same project and then coming up in the bounty session that he used, that used. Don't do that. Take care of this one, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, but the thing is, it can be like in the round one, it can be like they can argue that they have taken our idea or that thing. No.
Let me tell you that evaluation sessions will be completely private. In that session, only the mentors and your team will be there. No other person from any other team will not be there. So that will be a private thing. Okay. So whatever you discuss with the mentors in that evaluation session is totally safe, I would say, from other teams. Is that all right, Shashank?
Yes, sir. Sir, and I have one doubt too. Like, how can we get to know that the problem on my working is already solved in some hackathon or any other?
No. It's not about solving the problem. It's like, let me tell you what happens is in hackathons, people, what do they do? Like, if I participated in a previous hackathon, I made a project, I submitted it there, I win or I didn't win, that's different. But what I did, I submitted that project there. If I didn't win, I come up with that same project and I try to submit that project here also. So that is the issue. You cannot use same project for two consecutive, like two hackathons, similar, like you get it. Your idea should be somewhat varying or it should have been modified. Okay, now the thing is, if it has been solved, no issues, make sure you don't copy paste that idea, like completely, you don't copy paste that code, there, all those UI, UX, you shouldn't do that. Get it?
Yeah, thank you.
Yep. Okay, so project, okay, there are many doubts. I guess some of you should head to the Hacker Hangouts also. Okay, I'll be taking the last question now, then you can find my team in the Hackers Hangout. I'll be taking the last question. Sir, the project can be based on any problem or you will give the problem. Project can be based on any problem which you think should be solved and which you think you can solve it. It's up to you. Whatever you want, you can do it. It is open innovation. There are no limitations from our side. It is open innovation. You can build whatever you want. Sir, can you hack this Zoom Meet too? Obviously, you can if you want. And if you are successful to do that, you will be a reasonable candidate for prizes also. Okay, so I think that is pretty much it for this session. Rest of the doubts will be taken by my team in the Discord server itself. Okay, you can head to there. Are we good, team? Lakshay, Arshad, Pavan, Harsh.
Yes, we are good, Pradiman.
Okay, so
let's meet on Discord.
Yeah, let's meet on Discord because there are, like, I can see plenty of questions. So, okay, guys, that's all from our side for the introductions part. And we hope you have a great time. We'll be having one code chef hour today at 9 p.m. So you should go for it and try to win. All the best. Wishing you good luck.